This is not to say that fundamental religion is governed by alien forces, for we understand that fundamental religion has been well established in your world. What we are saying here is that the impulses for this, and the mechanisms for this will be supported by the visitors, and used for their own purposes. Therefore, great care must be given by all who are true believers in their traditions to discern these influences, and to counteract them if possible. Here it is not the average person in the world that the visitors seek to convince, it is the leadership. The visitors firmly believe that, if they do not intervene in a timely manner, humanity will destroy itself and the world. This is not based upon truth, it is only an assumption. Though humanity is at risk of self-annihilation, this is not necessarily your destiny. But the collectives believe that this is so, and so they must act with haste, and give their programs of persuasion great emphasis. Those who can be convinced will be valued as useful. Those that cannot be convinced will be discarded and alienated. Should the visitors become strong enough to gain complete control of the world, those who cannot conform will simply be eliminated. Yet the visitors will not do the destruction. It will be wrought through the very individuals in the world who have fallen completely under their persuasion. This is a terrible scenario, we understand. But there must be no confusion, if you are to understand and receive what we are expressing in our messages to you. It is not the annihilation of humanity, it is the integration of humanity that the visitors seek to accomplish. They will interbreed with you for this purpose. They will attempt to redirect your religious impulses and institutions for this purpose. They will establish themselves in a clandestine manner in the world for this purpose. They will influence governments and government leaders for this purpose. They will influence military powers in the world for this purpose. The visitors are confident that they can be successful, for so far they see that humanity has not yet mounted enough resistance to counteract their measures, or to offset their agenda. To counteract this, you must learn the greater community way of knowledge. Any free race in the universe must learn the way of knowledge, however it may be defined within their own cultures. This is the source of individual freedom. This is what enables individuals and societies to have true integrity, and to have the wisdom necessary to deal with the influences that counteract knowledge, both within their worlds, and within the greater community. It is, therefore, necessary to learn new ways, for you are entering a new situation with new forces and new influences. Indeed, this is not some future prospect, but an immediate challenge. Life in the universe does not wait upon your readiness. Events will happen, whether you are prepared or not. Visitation has occurred without your agreement, and without your permission. And your fundamental rights are being violated to a far greater degree than you yet realize. Because of this, we have been sent, not only to give our perspective, and our encouragement, but also to sound a calling, an alarm, to inspire an awareness and a commitment. We have said before, that we cannot save your race through military intervention. That is not our role. And even if we attempted to do so, and garnered the strength to carry out such an agenda, your world would be destroyed. We can only advise. You will see in the future a ferocity of religious belief expressed in violent ways, carried out against people who disagree, against nations of less strength and used as a weapon of attack and destruction. The visitors would like nothing better than for your religious institutions to govern the nations. This you must resist. The visitors would like nothing better than to have religious values shared by everyone, for this adds to the labor force and makes their task easier. In all of its manifestations, such influence fundamentally reduces down to acquiescence and submission, submission of will, submission of purpose, submission of one's life and abilities. Yet this will be heralded as a great achievement for humanity, a great advancement in society, a unification for the human race, a new hope for peace and equanimity, a triumph of human spirit over human instincts. Therefore, we come with our counsel, and encourage you to refrain from making unwise decisions, from giving your life over to things that you do not understand, and from acquiescing your discernment and your discretion for the sake of any promised reward. And we must encourage you not to betray knowledge within yourself, the spiritual intelligence with which you were born, and which now holds your only and greatest promise. Perhaps in hearing this, you will view the universe as a place devoid of grace. Perhaps you will become cynical and afraid, thinking that avarice is universal. But this is not the case. What is needed now is for you to become strong, stronger than you are, stronger than you have been. Do not welcome communications with those intervening in your world until you have this strength. Do not open your minds and hearts to visitors from beyond the world, for they come here for their own purposes. Do not think that they will fulfill your religious prophecies or greatest ideals, for this is a delusion. There are great spiritual forces in the greater community, individuals, and even nations, that have achieved very high states of accomplishment, far beyond what humanity has demonstrated thus far. But they do not come and take control of other worlds. They do not represent political and economic forces in the universe. They are not involved in commerce beyond fulfilling their own fundamental needs. They rarely travel, except in situations of emergency. Emissaries are sent to help those who are emerging into the greater community, emissaries such as ourselves. And there are spiritual emissaries as well, the power of the unseen ones, who can speak to those who are ready to receive, and who show good heart and good promise. This is how God works in the universe. You are entering a difficult new environment. Your world is very valuable to others. You will need to protect it. You will need to preserve your resources, so that you do not require or depend upon trade with other nations for the fundamental necessities of your life. If you do not preserve your resources, you will have to relinquish much of your freedom and self-sufficiency. Your spirituality must be sound. It must be based upon real experience, for values and beliefs, rituals and traditions can be used, and are being used by your visitors for their own purpose. Here you can begin to see that your visitors are very vulnerable in certain areas. Let us explore this further. Individually, they have very little will, and have difficulty dealing with complexities. They do not understand your spiritual nature. And they most certainly do not understand the impulses of knowledge. The stronger you are with knowledge, the more inexplicable you become, the harder you are to control, and the less useful you become to them, and to their program of integration. Individually, the stronger you are with knowledge, the greater challenge you become to them. The more individuals that become strong with knowledge, the more difficult it is for the visitors to isolate them. The visitors do not have physical strength. Their power is in the mental environment, and in the use of their technologies. Their numbers are small compared to yours. They are wholly reliant upon your acquiescence, and they are overly confident that they can succeed. Based upon their experience so far, humanity has not offered significant resistance. Yet the stronger you are with knowledge, the more you become a force that opposes intervention and manipulation, and the more you become a force for freedom and integrity for your race. Though perhaps not many will be able to hear our message, your response is important. Perhaps it is easy to disbelieve our presence and our reality, and to react against our message, yet we speak in accordance with knowledge. Therefore, what we are saying can be known within you, if you are free to know it. We understand that we challenge many beliefs and conventions in our presentation. Even our appearance here will seem inexplicable, and will be rejected by many. Yet our words and our message can resonate with you, because we speak with knowledge. The power of truth is the greatest power in the universe. It has the power to free. It has the power to enlighten. And it has the power to give strength and confidence to those who need it. We are told that human conscience is highly valued, though perhaps rarely practiced. It is this that we are speaking of when we talk about the way of knowledge. It is fundamental to all of your true spiritual impulses. It is contained in your religions already. It is not new to you. But it must be valued, or our efforts and the efforts of the unseen ones to prepare humanity for the greater community will not be successful. Too few will respond. And the truth will be a burden for them, for they will not be able to share it effectively.